They have reading anywhere in the world today, anywhere you go. This reading we have, we know, it's been preserved even to the dot, to the letter, to the vowel, to the sound. So what I will ask Hatun to do instead, and challenge her, and this is on the paper, to provide three examples of differences between the half readings anywhere in the world.
Brother, show him the examples.
Yes, so, we have.
Wait, stop. Daniel, so
that
now you
have. That is my claim. That is my claim.
In Speaker's Corner, that they have not changed even to the dots with the cut of his words. Oh, he said they are not even changed even to the dots, letters, and sounds. What he just heard, as he played back, I said, the half's reading, anywhere in the world, they have been preserved.
Preserved.
Hold on. They have been preserved. Even to the dots, letters, and sounds. And I stand by my claim, and I will demonstrate that to you. You have been first dishonest in claiming that I stated that not even a dot has changed. I didn't say
what?
That.
You did say that.
It's a preserve.
Even he doesn't get in his hand.
Don't you understand it?
Preserve. Now, brothers, what you do not understand. I said, our half reading has been preserved. Not only to the dots and letters, but also to the sounds.
What does preserve mean?
Wait, I will demonstrate it to you what I mean. Now, what do you understand by dots when it comes to the reading of
Hatun? Here's the problem.
I'm not interested to talk to a Decepticon. You can get all the help that you want from her, but I am not talking to this Decepticon. I will speak to you. No problem. You can get all the help that you need, even in the discussion. You can speak to her. You know what? How do I answer? No problem. But I will speak to you and you directly. Now. When I mention in relation to my statement about dots and sounds and letters, let me finish. What do you understand by dots in relation to reading?
He's been at the corner for long enough. Everyone knows Mansur is a good communicator. Everyone knows Mansur doesn't lack the communication skills. So, in somehow, Mansur wants us to unpack his statements where he says not even a dot changed in half Quran. Context of the debate, we were talking about how many Qurans are out there, and we were talking about the textual variations. The paper he gave it to us, it says three examples of differences between half Muslims. Brother, show him the examples.
Yes, we have.
Wait, stop. Daniel. So now
that is my claim. That is my claim. There's no different thing I'll say to you.
Daniel, listen.
You asked us for three examples between the halves.
Daniel. I've been asking for how long? Three examples of differences between the worst Qurans out of your 26 or 31 Qurans you have at home. Three examples of difference between the worst Quran and the half Quran. Have you heard any? Those of you on the paper, have you ticked those? Have you provided one example yet?
This is Surah 33.
This here is called what? Was Fatha on
Hamza.
Top.
This what is Hamza.
It's called what?
There's Hamza.
Yeah, Hamza. Okay, good, good. And this one
here.
And this one with Fat as well. Called what?
Where is Hamza? Where is Hamza in
okay.
here?
Okay.
Where is Hamza in this
do you
one?
Do you mind? Let me finish.
No, I'm asking you
this called what here?
Where is Hamza in here?
Can you let him speak?
You've got Elif and then there is Hamza.
This called what? We have agreed here, just called Hamza Fatha.
Yes.
And this here is called what?
There is Alif.
Alif Fatha. Pronounce this one Alif Fatha. What is the voice?
Yes, Alif.
No, no, this letter only was Fatha.
Ah, don't push!
Knowledge time.
Be honest!
Knowledge time.
The whole world is gonna watch
you. Just so.
They have freedom. Anywhere in the world today. Anywhere you go. This reading we know, it's been preserved even to the dot, to the letter, to the vowel, to the sound.
Why the sound is different?
Why is the sound and written is different, Mansur? The sound is
why
different.
Why it is different?
Keep talking about
why
the sound.
Why it is different?
Why is it different?
They are different.
Can I have a look?
I'll hold it for you.
Are you
going back?
Okay. Sorry, bro. Mind if I eat? Why are they? Okay. Sound?
Yeah.
Okay. Shall I read it to you?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you have... Fil-A'rabi yas'aluna. Did you hear what I said? Fil-A'rabi yas'aluna. Did that make any difference?
Let's check.
Do you have an Arab?
Yeah.
Okay. So, let me read. في الأعرابي يسألونا في الأعرابي يسألونا نفس الصوت أو not
show it to
him. Is it the same sound or different if you're Arab?
It sounds the same.
Thank you very much.
No,
very
no,
honest
no,
question.
No.
Second example.
We're all
second
example.
Read this.
Is
the pronunciation is exactly the same?
No.
Yeah.
Can you find Daniel? Last time when
exactly
I read,
is
it the same?
Wait, Mansur.
Yes, it's different. Thank you for confirming for us.
Can you read, please?
Can you read this?
I can.
Yeah, go ahead, read.
Yeah, read.
Which one is it?
And
يحسبون الأحزاب لم يذهبوا وإن يأتي الأحزاب يؤدوا. لو إنهم بعدون في الأعراب يسألون عن أنبائكم ولو كانوا فيكم ما قتلوا إلا قليلا.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do is so to make it a little bit easier, Can you just read this red color here and then read this one?
If he's honest,
here
I'm Arab.
So let's see.
Okay.
Can you just read, please?
Can you be quiet?
Can you please read?
The question is this one.
No, but the question is
answered. Do you mind just so we can all hear it?
Yeah,
just touch it.
Welcome to you.
يسألون this one.
Okay.
يسألون.
Okay, read
which one?
This one, يسألون.
No.
يسألون.
There's a sack in here. Yes. Not yesa.
Yes.
No, but there is no air.
No, no. This sack in yes, not yesa.
Are you Arab?
I am Arab.
No, Mansur, are you Arab?
I am Arab. So, can you read that again?
No. If you understand what he said, Daniel.
No, can you read the word?
But you see, there is no Hamza.
Can you read it?
So, because
no
of the Hamza,
me,
sound is different.
Exactly.
Can you
because
read
of the Hamza,
could you read,
sound is different.
I can read.
Go ahead, read.
Al-A'raba yasaloon.
No, wrong.
Read this one.
Okay, here.
Okay.
Yes, alone.
Can I ask you a question, sir?
So,
one question.
Praise be to God. Hatun did it. She provided zilch example of the difference between house and wash. Not between the house and the house, and the wash and the wash. Thank you so much, Hatun. Thank you so much for providing an extra ayah out of this 31 mushafs. Yes, Omo. Extra surah. Yes, Omo. I thank you again from the bottom of my heart.
So now, I I'm giving you another example.
Yes,
Let's carry on. Good. We haven't moved from the example.
Don't push it.
So, same voice or not?
Don't push the guy.
It's different.
He's already answered you.
No, you need to say. Speak to him, my brother.
The same voice or not? He already confirmed.
Al Fatha and Hamza Fatha.
The letter.
Does it have the same voice or not the same voice?
Inshallah. It's a language. It is Alif, Bay, Tay, Tay, Jim, Pay, whatever. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
However, when it comes to writing and reading, especially in the Quran, they cut some letters, and they represent it with something else.
So that was the example.
Yes, another example.
What's your name?
It has been confirmed. It is different.
My name is Mansur. What's yours?
And I'm going to look at
Move,
Gareth.
Excuse me, I'm talking to you, Mansur.
Yes.
The word that we read,
I've got another example.
Is it the same voice or not?
Some people pronounce it the same way, some other people pronounce it other way.
How would you pronounce it? Say again?
Yes, Alum and yes.
This is another recitation.
What you did? What you did?
You moved another recitation.
What you did? What you say?
There is one
thing. Are you serious?
What you have done? What you have done? What you have done? You have pronounced.
That's it.
So, wrongly, and I will tell you how you pronounce it wrongly.
Okay, he pronounced it wrongly according to Hafs.
Allow me.
Must
now,
I'm gonna move on.
Go somewhere else then. So what you read, Yasa Alun. No, the scene is Sakin. You don't say Yasa, it's Yes. Yes, make a sukun on the scene. So read it again.
Can I ask you to write sentence?
What I'm asking you is this. Is there a sakin in the scene?
Yeah.
Is there a sukun?
There's a sukun here.
Right. So, read it then. Read it. Read this one.
Yes.
Wait, read this.
Yeah.
Can you read it, please?
Please, sir, read it.
Loudly. La, yes. This one is la.
No, read the whole phrase.
The whole word.
La, yes, ta, dinuka.
Yeah? Yeah?
Read both of them.
Here. La yasta'dhunuka.
Now, so
this is different.
So,
I'll help you why.
Are we going to have a response to this or not? Why are you talking?
Why are you fighting this, with one another guy? Let me respond.
When you make waqaf,
Surah 39, verse 34. Writing is different. Pronunciation is different. Another example.
There's the three rules, yeah.
Surah 23, 13.
You pronounce the Hamza with a glottal stop.
Writing portion is different.
You say,
pronunciation is different.
Yes or no?
Pronunciation is different. Another example.
Simple, basic level Arabic from primary school.
Exactly.
When you make a stop on the Hamza,
basic level. Because writing is different because it contains the letter Hamza. Another example, writing is different, recitation is different.
Can you respect the camera a little bit?
Pronunciation is different. Another example, Writing
Who
is
cares about
different.
The camera?
Exactly.
Pronunciation
Who cares about the
is different.
Who told you to come and film
Claim.
Me?
Dot by dot, word by word, sound by sound. Sadly, yeah.
So,
to the grave.
Very
back
sad.
Anta,
very sad.
Another example. Another example. This is
Fata,
one of the disturbing examples.
Fata.
Sir, Quran makes it clear.
The old writing.
Quran is perfect
and
Arabic.
The new writing.
Yet two
you are
Arabic
about.
Speakers
yeah.
fighting
I agree
with one
you.
Another.
But
what about the perfect Arabic claim?
No,
Alif
no.
Hamza.
Dot by dot.
Alif Fata
by
is called
word.
A.
Sound
Hamza.
By sound
Hamza. Fata
is
called
so is it
A.
Perfect.
No, no, no. Like here.
Example,
like here.
This is
you see this?
From
this is this A. This Hamza is the head of the I. The grammarian cut. And then put there.
Claim,
the difference
is
the Alif.
Sound by sound.
The Alif.
So it has been corrupted.
Here's
one example to just deal with the grave.
No, no, no.
Just deal with the grave. Sound by sound, Quran, half Quran is exactly the same. Another example.
So there's nothing
no,
wrong in the Quran here.
Not true.
The Arabic style of
another
writing.
Another example.
Developed.
Destroys the
that's
claim.
Only
so,
by sound,
so it's different.
They
no, no,
are the same. They are different.
Exactly. So
they're
written.
Different.
They are written
here,
differently.
Here is
e. Pronunciation
here
is different.
E.
What
about
yeah.
Why here
I
the differentiate
e
here
different.
Is because
I and
the alif
e are
work
different.
So my question to you is which Quran will we have?
All of the signs of recitation.
All of the kinds of recitation.
We have the Quran
yeah.
in all of the
One kind of Quran, yeah. Yeah. What
all
what's the others? What's the others?
All the signs of recitation.
Right. Okay, you let's use the hafs. Okay?
Yeah.
Where does the hafs? Who's the reciter of the hafs? Who's the reader of the hafs? When was he born?
The Prophet
it's traced back to
Muhammad.
A particular
the Prophet Muhammad.
No. The hafs comes yeah. from a man born in the 9th century.
No,
you don't know your own history.
History
you don't know your own history. The Hafs reading
the
is dated to a man in the 9th century who never met Muhammad.
What's his name?
Who never
read. You're making a bold claim.
It's called Hafs. It's called Hafs.
It's called Hafs.
I don't know his full name.
He's correct.
It's something like Hafs Suleiman.
How you?
His name is something like named after Hafs.
Yes.
You see, again, I've made a claim and I'm not making up. This brother has verified two claims that I've made. I'm not making them up.
But he's a scholar.
Thank you. He's named after him, but he's a scholar. When was he born?
After Prophet Muhammad.
After the Prophet Muhammad.
Well,
so you have a Quran
get,
that you trace back to a man after Muhammad.
Where did he get it from? Where did the Hafs go?
That's the point.
Companions.
That's the point.
Where did the companions get it from?
Where is the evidence that he
it's
got it from Muhammad?
What was he reading? What was this Hafs guy that was born in the 9th century? What was he reading?
What was he reading?
Yeah,
thank
what was
you.
He reading? No, no, I'm asking what was he reading?
Well, I would suggest he's reading a text.
Yeah, yeah, a text by whom?
Text. Yeah, but what is the
Does
text
that text
reading?
Still exist today?
No, it doesn't. We don't have it. Oh, no, actually, from the 9th century we do. From the 9th
okay,
century.
Cool.
Sorry,
so then what was the point of making it?
Yeah.
If it existed before him and after him,
so let's look. So let's look at
making.
If you take the 9th, the Quran of the 8th century, of the 9th century,
yeah,
it's written in what script?
I don't know, you tell me.
Kufic.
Okay.
Right? You compare that to the modern day Quran, the 1924 version of the Quran. Are they dot for dot, word for word, and letter for letter the same?
Which style? Are they the same style?
Well, Kufic and then modern the Arabic
realize,
and the modern
you realize
Quran.
You realize Kufic is a completely different type of script, right?
Yeah, that's my point.
Yeah.
That's my point.
It's an older script.
Yeah, absolutely.
But that doesn't change anything to do with the
absolutely.
Meaning.
Yeah.
So what's the significance of the Birmingham manuscript? What's the significance of the Birmingham manuscript?
Well, the Birmingham manuscript was dated, and the carbon dating places it prior to Muhammad's revelation.
No. They only say the range.
Yeah, they give a range. They give a range. It is a wide range. So no more.
It
doesn't, yeah, and it doesn't match the 1924 version. Get the Birmingham manuscript, compare it to your 1924 version of the Quran, look at it page for page, they're not the same. But this is the point. This is the point, brother. If you take away the consonant, the vowel vocalization, you take all of that away, you couldn't read it.
Yeah, that's why you have to be taught and exposed.
Yeah, you couldn't read
that's
it.
That's why no man can just say it
just
the Quran.
So what we're saying is,
this is as simple as this. Your arguments would only be valid if the Quran was revealed as a book, not a recitation. That's the only way your arguments would be valid.
Yeah.
Other than that, it's a straw man.
So let me explain why it's not a straw man. Let me explain why it's not a straw man. When the Muslim armies were at the borders of Armenia before they invaded Christian Armenia, Muslims from different parts of the world who were not Arabs were fighting amongst themselves about how to recite the Quran.
Say that again, Christians.
The Muslims. Muslims were arguing about how to recite the Quran.
This happened to
this is in Sahih al-Bukhari. This is in Sahih al-Bukhari. I'm not making it up. Now, let me be clear. What was the response of Uthman to this disagreement amongst the Muslims? How did he respond? Do you know how he responded? He standardized the text. So his response to disagreement with the recitation was to make a book. So that means the Quran was a book.
But was it revealed as a book?
Pronounced Greek words. That's not even a concession. That's not even a concept.
I failed to see how my pronunciation of Greek words has any relevance to this discussion.
You don't even have a canon or a standardization on how to pronounce the words in the Bible. In fact, your point that you're trying to make is to our advantage, because watch this. Over 1,400 years, there were people from different areas in the entire world. When I go to Indonesia and he recites the Al-Fatiha, he recites it the same way I would recite it. That is a miracle.
Here's the problem with your analogy. It's that in Greek, the vowels are written.
Yeah, but you don't know how to pronounce it.
The Kufic script is solely consonantal in nature.
Right.
Yes. In Greek, the vowels are written, and so therefore, there is no need to canonize the standard way to pronounce, because the vowels are there in the text. The vowels were a later introduction to the Quranic manuscripts. They came after the time of Muhammad.
We know this.
What we're talking about at that point, the text is becoming standardized, and variations between the text means that they are different. There are different
Quran. Can I just make a point real quick?
And the recitation of the wash is different from the recitation of the Hafs. Mansur has already shown that.
So basically, your argument right now is that you don't believe the Quran is from God because there's more than one version. Is that what you're saying?
I am saying that if Muslims are consistent to their own belief, that if the Quran was from any other than Allah, bearing in mind that he said he would protect the book, and that there is clear evidence of textual differences between
if they were consistent to their own logic, would not believe in the Quran. From your standpoint, you're saying that you personally wouldn't believe in the Quran because there's more than one. There's two different ones, whether it be the recitation or whether it be the actual physical books themselves, one being the Kufic script, one being the Hafs, whatever they are.
Yeah, so I'm saying to you,
you're going to come back with a Bible.
He's trying to take a high standpoint, but really, when really and truly, there's no, from the 5,000 or approximate manuscripts that exist to the Bible today, not two of them match. So how can you, as a Christian, claim to be a Christian and profess your belief in Christianity and then turn around and try and criticize Muslims because they have a difference in pronunciation, or even let's give you the benefit of the doubt and say there's a difference in words.
Thank you.
Different difference in words.
So different texts.
Let's just give you for the benefit of the doubt, for the sake of the argument, that's the case.
Okay.
You Christians stand a lot more guilty than Muslims do.
Okay.
I can flip this argument as a 180 and do the exact same thing to you.
I'll explain why it's not a 180 and I'll explain why it's not applicable.
Why is that?
The difference between when I make this criticism of Islam, I am at least taking the time to understand what Muslims genuinely believe about their Quran. The idea that the Quran is nazil, word for word from Allah, ad verbatim, from the angel Gabriel to Muhammad and then copied down. So I've taken the time to understand your beliefs. In other words, in Islam, the message is the book and the book is the message. But your comparison to Christianity demonstrates to me that you don't understand what Christians believe about the Bible. Because our belief about the Bible...
You don't believe the Bible is the word of God.
Can I finish? We Christians don't believe that the message is the book. We believe that the message gave rise to the book. In other words, the message came before the book. So, therefore, if there are textual variations in Old Testament Greek manuscripts, so long as they don't affect the essential message, it's not a problem for us. However, because you believe that it's integral to your deen that the message and the book be identical, any change to the text is a change to the message. Okay. That's why it's a problem.
Okay. Where's the change in the text? Is it
Well, we had one from the brother that
is
was
Malik,
studying Malik,
Malik.
Just
a second. Malik.
Yeah, we use this one.
That's a change.
King and owner. Right, let me ask
that's
you this question.
In English,
let me ask you this question.
What's the contrary?
Yeah, let me ask you a question.
That's a change.
Let me ask you a question. Yeah. Is every king an owner? Huh? Is every king an owner?
But every king is... every king is,
is there, is there a contradiction? Is there a contradiction between
the two? I wouldn't be so petty. I wouldn't be so petty.
Hold on.
Let me be clear. Is every king an owner?
Don't even
avoid the question. Don't avoid the question.
I'm not going to avoid the question. And I'm going to say I do not know. Okay, fine.
Well, let me ask you a more obvious question. Let me ask you a more obvious question, one you can definitely answer. Is every owner a king?
No.
No. So therefore, these two words.
Okay.
I got it. These two words are different.
Okay. Owner of what?
Of something.
Owner of what? Every owner is
Malik
king
mean?
Of what he owns. No. Hold on. Owner of what?
Let's say everything.
No, but that verse that you're talking about. Owner of what?
Elaborate. Tell me.
Okay. When it says Malik Yawmuddin, it says the owner of the day.
Yeah.
So the owner here is specific to the day.
What's the day?
Day of judgment.
Okay.
And we also know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Malik.
Yeah.
So there's no contradiction in the meaning.
All right, one second. The king.
Hold on. Before you speak, I will let you go. Okay, yeah. Another thing. We know in the English language has that feature as well, connotations. Okay? Mm-hmm. A word has connotations.
Yeah.
Okay? A king
connotes
that he owns something.
Yeah.
So where's the difference in meaning there?
So, when it describes Allah as the king, is it describing Allah as the king only of the day of judgment, or is it describing the king as in the king of all things?
It says Maliki Yawmiddin, the owner
day,
of the day.
Right. He's the king of the day,
yes.
And he's the owner of the day. Yes. Is his sovereignty, calling someone a king is a question of his sovereignty. Is his sovereignty limited to the day, or does it go further?
There's no question to ask anymore. Another thing that's really funny here, which is he's trying to differentiate between the owner and the king when I've explained to him. Then another thing, the pronunciation is not even that different from Malik and Malik.
So what we've established, what I've established from listening to you,
where's the contradiction?
I never claimed it was a contradiction.
No, because you're saying
you
I never.
Contradiction.
You see, no,
you're
hold
saying
on,
in the text.
Okay, one second.
You're saying it's because Akram Das Muslim.
Brother, one second. Okay. No, from listening to you, what I've established is the following.
Everything.
What I've established is the following. Yeah. Firstly, my original claim that the texts were different is correct. There are differences in the text that you admit to. Secondly, that there are differences in words. That there are differences in words which you've also admitted. And that there are differences in pronunciation, which you have also admitted to.
He's got an ill style of arguing. One second. If he asks you a question, you don't adjust every little point.
What you did do is reconcile the exposition of the words. You reconciled the hermeneutics, the way, the theology that you draw from it, you have said is the same. And I don't disagree with you. I agree with you. My point to you is that Muslims, for years now, for decades, until recently in Speaker's Corner, like Mansur has abandoned this position, have claimed that all Qurans are identical. How many times have we heard Muslims say every Quran in the world is the same? That there is only one Quran. Well, the evidence is clearly saying there's more than one Quran.
There's only one Quran, but different recitations.
For the reasons that I've just given.
Okay, you said to me,
I'll let you have the last word and then I'm going to go.
Okay, that's fine. Basically, what we established here is this. When you say that the Quran, because of its pronunciation, is different, right? What then?
Malik king or owner, which one is it? But it takes the pronunciation to be written. So
yeah. Maliki, it's the pronunciation.
Which one?
It's written the same.
Which one?
If it's written in the Quran.
It's written exactly the same.
Huh?
Yes.
Malik.
No, it's not a vowel.
No.
Even if it's the vowel.
And they don't mean the same. So you have two texts.
No, is that the same word?
What?
Does this sound the same? Melik and Melik. Does that sound the same to you?
That was the way that when you pronounce it like that, but when you pronounce it earlier, you pronounce it differently. You changed the pronunciation to suit yourself.
There have been debunked
several times. And in your heart, you know that. You stand before God.
Honestly, you always must be honest.
You stand before God. Always be honest.
This is the team you knew. I have told you. I'll tell you when I'm wrong.
I said I would give you the last word. So let's finish your last word and then I'm going to go.
First of all, you have established things up on me, which I don't agree with, because the first question when you asked me, I did not understand the question, so I said I do not know. So you haven't established anything on me. Okay, that's the first thing. Secondly, you are stretching. It's far-fetched what you're doing here. You're stretching. You look at something that isn't. Stop stretching. What are you stretching for? You're looking at a word in pronunciation.
You know what?
And then when you look at the word that has connotation, I'm telling you, owner of what? You didn't even know. So you don't even know the context of that ayat. So how can I talk to you?
Okay, is that your final word?
Yeah, that's my final word. So do the research and stop stretching words.
People can make their own judgments whether I've made things up or whether you've evidenced anything. People can come to their own conclusions. Anyway, it was nice talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you for engaging. Thank you for engaging. Have a lovely day.
So again, we came to Speaker's Corner with responding the claim that within the Hafs Quran, it has been preserved perfectly, dot by dot, sound by sound, word by word, it's preserved. So today we showed some example to Mansur, he's part of the Islamic Dawah team. We showed him example from Surah 33, Surah 9, Surah 72, which changed the sound and which changed the written version of the Hafs Quran. When you look at them, you see there is letter Hamza, which changed the sound. You see there is letter Alif. In some of the versions of the Hafs Quran, it is not there, yet in some of the Hafs Qurans, it's there. So it is sad to see once again, Mansur didn't want to engage, probably, but we respond to the claim which has been made by Islamic Dawah team. In the Hafs Qurans, which is all around the world, dot by dot, word by word, sound by sound, it has been preserved. And that wasn't true. We just made our point today. Yet, I think it's helpful to remember, Muslims already give up the Quran of Muhammad. Muslims already give up the Quran of Abu Bakr, which was the first Quran. Muslims already give up the perfect Quran of Uthman. And now they are trying to hold on something which is written approximately 200 years after Muhammad, somewhere called in Kufa. That's the Hafs Quran. And today we saw again, Hafs Quran is not reliable, as Imam Hafs was not reliable either. Thank you, sir. So we've got different Hafs Qurans out there. We've got 7 different Mushafs I have got in my possession. Also, I've got 3 online Hafs Quran, different versions, and they are different from one another. Altogether, 10 Hafs Qurans out there, word by word, sound by sound, dot by dot. They are different from one another.
In the end and in summary, I have to say that Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, in the course of discussion, we have established with evidence from manuscripts, with evidence from your examples, with evidence from reason, intellect, with evidence from resorting to authentic hadith, unlike you cherry picking our hadiths, misunderstanding our hadiths, that there is one Quran of Muhammad.